I'm putting in a lot of mileage at the minute.
Like, the things that I look at straight away on the bike.
So first impression straight away, look at these roads. So today's been a good day.
Hi, my name's Thomas Martinez, and I've had a lot of hobbies over the years that I fit in between my full-time job as a tattoo artist. But now it's time for my journey into the pursuit of speed and adventure. I am the cycling tattooist. I wish you
bluebird. In 1 mile at the roundabout, take the first exit onto A127 towards London.
So, welcome back. Today is an exciting day. As you may have guessed by the title of the video, I'm off for a bike fit. Now, I already got a bike fit when I first got the bike, but since then, I have changed a few little bits and bobs. So, it's always a good idea to go get another bike fit, especially if you've changed things such as the pedals and the cleats. And that's exactly what I've done.
At the roundabout, take the first exit onto A127 towards London.
All right, Siri. I have changed quite a few things since that bike fit, when I upgraded to the power meter Garmin pedals. And then I also have changed my seat and also my shoes as well. So yeah, even though I'm not gonna be far off of where I need to be, there's definitely going to be some slight alterations that need to be made. And I have had some little niggles from time to time. These problems have got a little bit better on their own, but I think that is mainly due to the fact that I'm putting in a lot of mileage at the minute. So yeah, I think maybe I'm just getting used to being uncomfortable, which is something that you don't really want to do. You want to be as comfortable as possible on the bike. So yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing if seeing how far off I am from where I should be, and hoping that it's gonna make a difference and make me more comfortable. Now I'm going to see a guy called Callum Riley, who was recommended to me, and the company is called Velo Insight. It's based in Saffron Walden. I've never been to see Callum, but I've heard a lot of good things. So yeah, looking forward to seeing what he can do for me. I've made a massive schoolboy error straight away, checking the time that it took to get there last night, when obviously there wasn't any traffic. And now it looks like I'm gonna be running late in true Thomas style. But yeah, Saffron Walden's not too far from me. It's only meant to be around about an hour. Let's get ourselves there and get to this bike fit.
Cool, I'll catch you in a second.
Alright, see you in a bit.
Bye.
Bye. I wish you. Cool.
Yeah, so this is the place, yeah.
Yeah, it's nice, right?
Yeah. It's took a long time to get to this, but we got there in the end. It's open in August. Because I was meant to open in April, but everything obviously shut us down. Opened in August, it was rammed up until November, then we had that second little lockdown. And then December was a bit quieter because I had people booked in for December, but they were like, they were just coming out of lockdown, it was Christmas coming up. They were like, can we move to January? I didn't book anyone in January because I didn't think we were going to be coming out of Christmas back into work, so I didn't move people in January.
I've been dealing with the same thing, like I do tattoos, so. Yes. I've been battling it always, so it's been a nightmare, isn't it?
And then we managed to open, when we opened on the 12th, like I've just been non-stop. Like the things that I look at straight away on the bike, the visual point of view and what I kind of look at is, I want to move the hoods. The only reason I say that is, just for your hand mechanics. Okay. So people don't necessarily think about this.
No.
I don't know what your reach is like yet, but just out of the gate, so like, this to this, 24 degrees. I normally work at 30, 33. So if you look on my hood, hoods are higher.
Oh, yeah.
The hand actually sits in it, not around, like that, actually in it. This actually locks this joint better. So actually it just stabilizes the rest.
So like here you're more round, so if I was like in that position, you're more round, whereas if you took it up that 5 degrees,
yeah,
that position, and it's marginal things, it really is, and sometimes they get overlooked. Quite interesting to see that when you were given a slightly skinnier saddle, you sat rather back, and that's what I was kind of hoping to see. How did you respond to this?
That's something I've been consciously like trying to do. Should I like no?
No.
I'm just like in the right.
Should
try and sit.
No. You sit perfectly in the middle of the saddle.
Quite interesting. Turns out I wasn't too far off of where I needed to be, which I did think that was going to be the case. He ended up moving my saddle position quite a bit, shifted me back, seems to be doing the trick. So, but obviously time will tell, and he's told me to obviously go away and get some riding in and see how I feel. He certainly seems like a guy that knows what he's talking about, and you can tell that he's got a real passion for it. So it's nice to see someone that's passionate about their job, as am I. But yeah, really happy with how it went, and I'm gonna take his advice, and I'm gonna get out on a ride right now. Nothing crazy, around 40k. It'd just be nice to give the bike a test with the new position, and yeah, hopefully I get on with it. We're on the road, just having a nice chilled one. Oh, look, bit of thatch. I love a thatch cottage, I do. So first impression straight away is one of the big things he changed was he actually moved my levers. So the hoods are now quite a bit more upright than they was before, which is something I never even thought about changing, to be honest, and didn't realize how much of an effect it would have. But that's certainly the first thing I'm noticing. The hand comfort is so much better. I don't think I even realized that I had discomfort in my hands until now. Instantly, I feel way more comfortable on the bike. The other changes he's made have been only slight changes, but I can already feel that they're having a positive effect as well. Obviously, only time will tell, and I'll see if it's still feeling good in a little while. But I'm very hopeful. Good news. Thanks.
What a good place to do a U-turn. Some people. I'm 22 kilometers in now, so about halfway on this little loop that I'm doing. Still very positive, feeling very comfortable. I've always known that bike fits are a good idea ever since I had my first one. If you haven't had one before, I do really recommend getting one. You just wouldn't believe the difference some slight changes can make. You might even be like myself where, you know, you feel comfortable, or so you thought, and then it isn't until someone that knows what they're talking about looks at you and says, well, hang on a minute, we might need to make a little change. And that's when you realise things can be even more comfortable. And who doesn't like a bit of comfort? Anyways, I'm going to get my head down. I ain't got a clue where I'm going. And even though I've got a Garmin, I still have almost turned the wrong way a few times already. So yeah, I'm going to crack on and I'll see you back at the car.
Wounder.
Bloody puncher. I was cruising along then, enjoying myself. I was actually going quite fast. That could have been a lot worse. It's never fun having a high speed front puncher, but luckily it was only a little trickler. It weren't a blowout, so I'm all good. As much as I love these tyres, which I said about on a previous episode, they're the TT, I think they're called the Velo TT, Pirelli ones. Yeah, super nice tyre, super fast, but they are a little bit on the thin side. Now, I haven't been that unlucky with punchers, but it seems recently I have. Pirelli do another tyre called the Race, I think it's called, or it's basically the clincher version of the Race TLR. Maybe I'll try them next. Anyways, I've got about 10k left. Just cruise back to the car now. It's absolutely beautiful out here. Lovely roads, albeit some of them not very well surfaced, but look at these roads. Bloody beautiful. Anyways, I'll see you back in the car. So, just got back to the car. As I was riding through the high street, I noticed the subway. That subway was delicious, but £11.40. I thought he was joking.
They must be lacing the bread with cocaine or something. But anyways, that was a lovely little loop I done. Just over 40 kilometers. I took it pretty easy. I averaged just over 30 kilometers an hour. Although I did manage to bag myself a comp. And I got 3 top 10s as well. So not bad for a little bimble. I did have a bit of a killer tailwind at one point, but you know, let's not mention that. It's all my power. So today's been a good day. Again, really nice to meet Callum and really happy with the bike fit. Just from that short ride I've done there, I can tell that that is gonna make a big difference. I'm already feeling more comfortable on the bike, which is something I didn't expect to feel straight away. I thought it was gonna make me feel a little bit maybe uncomfortable or just not used to the new position. But if anything, I actually straight away was used to the position and definitely feeling some benefits off the back. Most notably the hand position. I know I mentioned it on the ride, but I just can't believe how much difference it made. Just bringing them hoods back that little bit. It's really just made me feel a bit more sort of confident and a nice firm grip on the bars now. And with my wrists in a more comfortable position. So all round it has definitely been worthwhile getting a new bike fit. And like I mentioned before, I definitely recommend getting one if you haven't ever, or if you're like me and you've made some slight alterations. Yeah, it's a good idea to go get another bike fit because you might be surprised. If you're local to me or just live around Essex in general, then I really recommend Callum. He's based in Saffron Walden and he's got a lovely little studio there and the guy really knows his stuff. So yeah. If you're looking for a bike fit, go check him out. If you do want to get in touch with Callum, then his details are in the description below. So, as ever, I hope you've enjoyed this episode. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you next time. Yeah.